Hi, Dr. Ken here, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. We've got some great fun science tricks for you today. We are going to be using the incredible, the amazing Astrojax. This is a toy with a lot of science behind it. I'm going to show you some tricks, do some experiments, and I'm going to get you to make one of your own. All you need is one of these things. Yep, this is a washer, or you could use a nut, and a piece of string. Oh yeah, just one thing. It's never too late to click and subscribe so you won't miss out on the next installment of Dr. Ken's cool science tricks. All right, what is this? Well, let's have a look. It's made from one, two, three balls, and don't need that. These three balls, they're all made of rubber, all bouncy rubber. Two of them are attached like so, and they don't move. This one actually slides between the two. And what you do is you hold one in the middle like this, and then I'm going to let go of one side. I'll let go of this side and see what happens. So I'll just take a step back. Are you ready? How about that? Yeah, it's amazing, isn't it? It's actually rotating about the center one. The outside one is rotating about the center one. I'm actually having to pull this upwards. And as I'm pulling upwards, it gives it enough energy to keep going. But it's quite a chaotic system. If you just keep going up and down, it doesn't work. So you've got to sort of time when you apply the force and how much force. But I do find it is a bit weird, because when you let go, most people think that this is just going to fall down like this, as opposed to pivoting about the center. In an earlier video, I showed you how to throw a knot in a piece of string, which does use a very similar force to that, a pull force, just like that, a pull and a push force. So you're probably thinking, how come that doesn't get knotted? Well, I've got a little experiment here to show you why. So what I've actually done is, if you actually look on this one here, I put a little piece of tape. And if I just do the trick and drop it like so, you'll actually see how it rotates about the center to stop the actual string from getting knotted and twisted. So that rotation, that free rotation in the middle, does help that. Here's a trick. This middle one, I'm going to swing like so. And then I'm going to get let go of the bottom one and see what happens. If I keep that swing going, you'll notice that that bottom one is rotating around it, like it's in orbit around it. And that force is called a centripetal force. And that centripetal force is the same force that the Earth and Moon has between it, that sort of gravitational force. Of course, in terms of the Earth and the Moon, there isn't a piece of string attached to it. But there's still that centripetal force. If I take this like so, and just swing it round, it creates a circle of a constant radius. That's why it's called a circle. If I take this in the middle, like so, and then I just swing it and then pull and relax. Notice as I pull it, there's a lot of tension in the actual string. And as I relax, because of that tension, it goes back. No longer is this a constant radius. The radius is constantly changing. As I pull it in, the radius gets smaller and it gets faster. So I've actually increased the momentum. And as it gets longer, it actually slows down. So what's actually happening here is I'm using something, or taking advantage of something called the conservation of momentum. Now, this conservation of momentum is what ice skaters use when they want to spin really fast. Because if you spin with your arms outstretched, you're slow. But if you pull them in, you go a lot faster. So why don't you give it a go? All you need is a piece of string about this long, 70 centimeters, and it's quite thin but strong. I've tied a washer to each end, and I've also got the one that can fly down the middle quite easily, really fast. So let's see if it works. So first of all, the trick. Yeah, that works. In fact, it works quite well. It's not getting knotted, which is good news. What about the orbit? Okay, fingers crossed. I'll just let go. In fact, that's very effective. In fact, that's somewhat easier than using the Astrojax. All right, what about the last one? Let's see if that works. So I'm holding it in the middle like this. Give it a little swing. Oh yeah, that works too. Fantastic. So all you need, some very simple items, and you can try it too. These Astrojax are a really cool, fun science trick. If you want to get a hold of them, I'll leave a little link in the description. Finding this particular type, you might need to try eBay. But before you do anything, before you spend any money, please, bit of string, three washers, you can't go wrong. Oh, thanks again for stopping by my YouTube channel and checking out the science behind the Astrojax. Don't forget, if you want to find out about other videos, click and subscribe, or check out some of my other science videos I've already made. With a bit of practice, you'll be doing this in no time whatsoever. I do hope you have a load of fun finding out all about it and maybe creating your own experiments. Don't forget, show your friends, show your school teachers, and try and explain a little bit of the science behind it too. But the main thing is, have loads of fun.